With silence comes peace. With peace comes freedom. With freedom comes silence.
So people love to wear slogans and expressions on their masks. I've seen a million Black Lives Matter masks. They're very popular with some folks. How about this? I'm speaking. It's something that Kamala Harris said during the vice presidential debate. People like that. Here's another mask with a beautiful message. Jesus loves me. What could be wrong with that? Well, for the administrators of a certain elementary school in Mississippi, was a big problem. That is Lydia Booth. She is a third grader, and back in October, she was sent to the principal's office when she was wearing this mask. They told her to take it off, saying that it violates school policy. Well, this has become a major deal right now. I think that sounds pretty unfair to me, but let's get into it with Lydia Booth. She is the third grader, along with her mom, Jennifer Booth. Welcome to you both. And we also have your lawyer, Tyson Langhofer, senior counsel at the Alliance Defending Freedom. Welcome to you all. Nice to see you.
Thank you.
So Lydia, first to you.
Nice to see
you. Absolutely. Thanks for being here. Lydia, tell us a little bit about what happened to you.
Well, this mask I had said Jesus loves me, and in the beginning of school, nobody said anything about it. Well, later on, the computer teacher said I couldn't wear that type of mask. Well, after my mama said that it was not an actual policy, she said that the next day, the principal walked in my room, winked at me, said my name, went to go tell my teacher something. After that, the assistant teacher said for me to put on this other mask so nobody would say anything or lead any more trouble happening.
Trouble happening. And again, the mask says, Jesus loves me, which is a beautiful message. I don't know how anyone could have a problem with it. Now, let's put this statement up, though, from the school. They said that their policy prohibits political, religious, sexual, or any inappropriate symbols, gestures, or statements that may be offensive, disruptive, or deemed distracted to the school environment. Now, this is certainly religious, but I am curious, I guess, did you notice anyone else wearing masks with any kind of message, and were they treated like you?
Lydia?
No, sir.
So, Jennifer, if you don't mind, I'm hearing that other people were wearing any kind of mask, and it was okay. Black Lives Matter, Kamala Harris, Biden, whatever you want, but they singled her out. Is that how it went down?
Yes, sir. Our son goes to the high school, and he said that, I mean, pretty much whatever mask you could think of politically. And she even seen, you know, T-shirts on the bus, sports logos and name, I mean, whatever, you know. So it just, this whole thing comes as a shock.
So you have a lawyer now. And you have a lot of support. Yeah. A lot of letters have been coming in. Tyson Langhofer, I'm sure you've seen the documents. You've seen their statement. Tell us what this is about. Do they have a case here or do you?
No, you know, it's really clear. Elementary school students don't forfeit their religious freedom when they walk into the school. And what happened here was that the school targeted Lydia's speech, her mask, because it was religious. And that's a clear violation of the First Amendment. Public school teachers have no business censoring students who just want to simply share their deeply held religious beliefs, but allowing others to express different messages.
Now, it does say, according to this, was this policy or not, the school statement that they prohibited political, religious, sexual, or, you know, on and on and on, anything deemed disruptive? Did they have that official policy?
Yeah, here's the problem. They didn't have that policy until after Jennifer called them on that. They actually made that up after the fact in order to justify them making Lydia take that off. But even if it was the policy, the problem is the government cannot discriminate against certain viewpoints. They lumped religious speech into inappropriate speech, and along with inappropriate speech or political speech. And they can't target that type of speech, but allow other speech, such as Black Lives Matter or such as sports logos and things like that.
Yeah, no, that makes total sense to me, what you're saying.
Welcome to Still Shadows.